Hello, in this lesson we're going to speak about several operators which are quite complicated to distribute to some of logical departments. It will be the ray, line thick and wireframe SOP.
Ray can project points coming from the first input to the geometry of the second input. Let's imagine we have some geometry. For example, let's take the grid controlled by noise. That will be the shape where we want to project. And let's make some, for example, we can make text. Let's make just some letter. And we can put it here. In order to make that work, you can see that already some points of that F starts to displace. So let's adjust a bit. We can make the shape bigger. And now you can see that points of the letter sometimes projecting on the grid. Why? Because if we check from the side, the original F letter is in the middle and noise is displacing shape in positive and negative Z axis. So in ray, we use a project race method and it uses the source normal. We can use collision normal. We can use reflected ray. Let's just move our shape using the transform in front of our grid by Z axis. And maybe we will need more details on that text. So let's output open polygons. And in order to increase the amount of details, we can use the resample operator. Let's now enable the resample display flag, and using display options in the geometry viewer, we can enable the points. Let's resample by polygon edge and let's decrease the step. Okay, now no points are projecting on the grid. That is because of normal direction. So let's check which direction have the normals on the letter. So it has basically no normals, which we can generate using the point SOP. And let's add normal, delete expression and use Z axis. And let's make normals looking in negative Z direction. And now you can see that it's projecting on the shape of a displaced geometry. So that is a simple example how we can use the ray. If not all points are colliding, you can also use the create point group, then it will add automatically the collided point to the group. You can add a bunch of control, oversampling, jitter, safe bounds geometry, point intersection distance, then it will generate distance attribute where you can control the distance between original point and projected point. That's all very usable information. You can also enable intersect farthest surface, and you can use the minimum distance, but that algorithm is very slow. Okay, that's all about the next operator. Is very simple. Let's create, for example, a circle. Then let's open it, make open arc. Then we can use that operator, which called line thick, which can produce nice shape around the lines. Let's check what we have here. So first division will increase the details, then rows. So let's make the wireframe mode so you can see original circle and line result of work of line thick. Then we can change the start and end point for that operator. Then we can make easy in, easy out cubic interpolation. And what is interesting, we can make symmetric. Then we can control start weave offset, basically that is offset to inside and outside, and the same for the end start weave and end weave. So using that operator we can actually create very nice shapes around the splines. And last operator I want to show is wireframe. Let's make a sphere and let's make it polygon. Reduce, remove details, and we can apply wireframe operator and it will generate a wireframe tubed geometry. So let's check what is the output. It produced the primitive geometry. So it put tubes on edges and it put spheres on points. So that's why it's very fast. We can disable round corners. In that case, it will produce only tubes. We can remove polygon or disable remove polygon, that the original geometry will stay. We can make end caps and we can use fast wire, which will produce the a bit different result, much faster. And then we can convert it to polygons. So that's our options with wire operator. Okay, that was all about the modeling tools. And in the next lesson, we're going to speak about that group of operators I called workflow, because they are about the pipeline.
Thank you for your attention. In the next lesson, number 7, we'll be speaking about the cutting geometry tools. Please subscribe on us on YouTube and subscribe to our professional newsletter on howtotouch.com, and you will be receiving the free lessons, free projects and updates about our online and offline events. Thanks a lot and see you next week.